I'm Elie Setback reporting.
Okay, this is the one question for Bermain, and that is that since your first fight with Deontay, you've only had one fight in the interim, and that was towards the end of 2015, 10-round decision over Derek Rossi. You turned 39, I believe, on November 1st, a couple of days before this fight. Given your inactivity and the age factor, you were 3-2, very slight underdog the first fight, 25-1 for this one. How can you, I'm sure that you're going to say you're going to do better, but how can you be better given all those factors?
They're not factors to me. That's factors for people like you and the people that's out there. Age is nothing but a number. When I'm not, I can't say that I'm not inactive. I mean, when it comes to fighting, to be in the ring, you can say that. But as far as being inactive, I haven't been inactive. I've been in the gym all day, every day. And the fight with Rossi, that's not even a fight that I wanted to take. I just took the fight just because. For the past 3 years since I lost the title, there's only one fight that I'm interested in, which is the fight that's happening on November 4th. And, I didn't see, I was still trying to, at the time when I fought Rossi, I was still trying to digest the loss and everything like that. So, I might have been there physically, but mentally, psychologically, it was not really the case, when you look at it right now, all of that is all in the past. That was then, and this is now. And people are trying to say that my inactivity is going to hurt me or other things to be saying. I don't believe so. I know so. I know that I'm ready. I'm way, way more ready than the first fight. What can I say, man? I mean, talking about the past and what happened in the past, it's not something that I'm interested in, So the first fight, we all know what happened. Everybody that knows me, that knows how I fight, that knows Burmester, they know that wasn't me. But, hey, I'm not trying to look for no excuses, but what I'm telling you is this second fight, it's going to be a whole different fight. There's going to be a whole different ending.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Our next question is going to come from Dan Raphael from ESPN. Please go ahead.
Thank you very much. I'd like to start with a question for Bermain. You were just talking about how you just wanted this fight compared to any other fight during your layoff, but I was wondering why. I know you had the fight canceled at the end of last year with Povetkin because he had a positive drug test, so you and Deontay both have that in common with fights being canceled. But what was the reason that there was no fights for you at all in the calendar year of 2016? You had the Rossi fight in November and then a whole year without a fight and then the whole first half of 17 with no fight either.
I was scheduled to fight in 2016, I got injured, and I had to pull out two different fights.
What was that? What was the first? What was the fight you got injured for? Did you have an opponent?
Yes, I did. I did. Can't remember which card it was going to be, but it was set to. I was set to fight in 2016 two times. The first time I got injured. My ankle, and I had to pull out, and then I came back, I got ready, and I injured again, so I had to pull out again, and that's what happened.
And then the second fight was supposed to be the one against Povetkin that was canceled.
No, actually, before the Povetkin fight, I had some time to rest. I was actually on a wheelchair, right before going to camp for Povetkin, and I got cleared off. I think I was on chair for like about 11 weeks.
Uh-huh.
And I was set to the doctor cleared me to go back and run and do what I do. So that's when the fight with Povetkin was announced, and you know, we all know what happened.
Right. All right. So the ankle's good now. There's no injuries, no issues going into this fight.
No, nothing. I don't have any injuries. Nothing is basically this fight right here has no excuses.
Okay, fair enough.
To me, it's not going to be no excuses. I'm 110% ready, mentally, physically. So it's just, you know, I'm really happy that it happened the way it happened. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, God answers prayers, and the way it happens, you know, it was just something that I knew that was going to happen. So it is where it is right now. So it's only a matter of a couple of days, a week away, or, you know what I'm saying? So we ready to go. I'm, like I said, man, I'm healthy. I'm ready. And there's nothing else to say.
All right. Well, I wish you good luck in the fight. I have a couple of questions for Deontay. Hey, Deontay.
Hey, what's good?
One thing I wanted to ask you, you know, I think one of the other guys asked you about, you know, where you were at. Maybe Lou said where you're at right now as far as mentally. And I know you're saying all the right things, but how is it for you to try to avoid a letdown? Because you already have the win against DeVern. You won the first fight very handily. And the fight with Ortiz, of course, was a much more anticipated fight by the public. I think a much more anticipated fight by you, certainly by the press. How do you avoid a letdown going in this rematch?
How do I say that last part again?
How do you avoid a letdown, like a mental letdown, because it's not the caliber of fight that you were expecting, training for, and that everybody else was expecting?
You know, God bless you with certain abilities that you be able to have to with handle. You know what I mean? It's just like, man. I mean, as a black man, I've been through so many different things, man. Just even when I was born, coming on this earth, you know what I mean? You know. So you know, with that being said, this is just another obstacle that I had to deal with, that I had to face. I know that's why I don't never give my hopes up on nothing unless I know unless it's up to me. You know, if when you put it in others' hand or in man's hand. You're not sure. You're not sure if things going to come through or not. So with that fight, you know, I think I put so much into it. I'm like, this is Ortiz. He's been wanting it. He wanted this fight to happen. I never thought in a million years that he would do what he did, you know. And no matter what they say, it was done. It was a banned substance. You can't get around that. Y'all make mistakes in there because they tried to get their leverage. They tried to get edge. But it's a lot of guys that's doing it, though. I know each and every last one of them as well. It's a lot of them doing it, you know. And it's like, what the point of coming out and saying who's doing it when, at the end of the day, if you get caught doing it, what's the punishment? It's really nothing. When you can take care of that and get back in the rankings, and still be an active contender or become a mandatory or something like that. So what really is it doing? Like, you know,
he is losing probably a seven-figure payday by not fighting you next week. So that seems like a pretty good punishment to me.
Yeah. Yeah. But you know, at the end of the day, money is money. Money comes and go. Damn. Money comes and go. It's not everything.
Reporting.
Turn up the volume and just sit back. You're rocking with the best. Ellie Setback. The wave of the future. We don't lose. Tell me what you're watching. ES News. He came a long way. All the way from Jerusalem. Heavy on the grind. Competition, he abusing them.